welcome to my video. It's great to have you along. We've got a very busy legislative program ahead of the House at the moment. We've gone into urgency for the purpose of principally passing the Canterbury Earthquake Recovery Bill. That will set up CERA, or what is better known in its long term, Canterbury Earthquake Recovery Agency. That will have the purpose to ensure that the cultural, social, environmental well-being of Canterbury is met in the recovery of the building. It will have a direct line to government. It's something that the government will be concentrating on for this year, is to make sure that we do a first-class job in addressing the needs of those people affected by the earthquake. Another bill that was included in the urgency motion was the Education Amendment Bill number 4. That deals particularly with the tertiary education sector. It will enable the NZQA, or the New Zealand Qualifications Authority, to have the appropriate functions and powers that it's needed. Effectively, the New Zealand Qualifications Authority was set up in 1990 and has not had any other amendments since then. So for 21 years, it's done its job very ably at the cutting edge of at its time. But now it needs to be remodified so that it has those appropriate functions and powers. It has responsibility for some 6,000 qualifications, and the Minister of Tertiary Education, Stephen Joyce, is presently going through those qualifications and ensuring that they are appropriate, and I would expect to see that reduced in number. At the end of this urgency motion, we will go into recess for 2 weeks. And that will give me the opportunity of being able to get around the electorate again. It's a very large electorate, and those issues within that electorate continue to feature. I met with the ECAM commissioners last week and continued our conversation about how the zone committees are going around reaching a resolution on how we can store water and manage both water volume, water quantity and water quality in Canterbury. So I talked to David Bedford, and he spoke to me about something that we've all known in the rural community for some time, and it's something that we've really got to bridge, and that is the divide, or the difference in thinking between city people and the rural community. So that's the very purpose of the Zone Committee, is that we can reach an agreed position on storing water, because economically it's something that we cannot afford to keep on putting off. So that is well into the stage of where decisions are going to have to be made, and they will be serious decisions, and it won't be a decision that is going to please everybody. However, what will come out of it will be a consensus, so that's very good. Next week I've also got Dr. Wayne Knapp coming into the electorate. We worked really hard at the beginning of the 2008, when National came into government, to ensure that we picked up the loose ends around the C-130 upgrades, and to ensure that they were done at Woodburn Military Base. So Dr. Wayne Knapp is coming down, and we are going to inspect the C-130 that's presently in there for its upgrade, and that's that will be very satisfying. They tell me it's in the hangar, it's got its wings off, so they're going into some very deep maintenance, and that will take about 12 months to come out. While I've got Dr. Knapp with me, I will certainly take up the conversation with him about the possibility, or the probability, we should be more positive, shouldn't we, of a Skyhawk being in the Aviation Heritage Hangar in the short term. So it's going to be a very interesting time in the electorate. On the 19th of April, we've got Jonathan Coleman coming in, so that will no doubt be good from the point of view of the Freeview television. It's been an issue in the electorate around Marlborough that they're not getting terrestrial television directly beamed in from Wellington, even though we're only 30 kilometres away. It has been subject of many letters to the editor, and it will be quite good to have Dr. Jonathan Coleman come in and actually speak with the Marlborough Express journalists and just keep that matter before people as to them requiring to get a satellite dish and Freeview and have it beamed in by satellite. So again, it's all going very well for the national government, even though the economic times are somewhat difficult. It just shows you how important it is to be adaptable and also to have a very competent cabinet. So again, thank you very much for listening to my blog site and my video, and I certainly enjoy talking to you and keeping you updated on what's happening in Parliament here. So do have a very good April, and I look forward to catching up with you again when we get back into Parliament. Thank you.